to the concert tonight. We're just thrilled at the turnout. I'm Terry Lupo, president of the Band Boosters for Centerville High School, and we are proud to sponsor the Louis Belson concert. And I'm here to introduce a former Centerville graduate, Johnny Mack. He's the daytime DJ for WMUB Radio, 88.5 on your FM dial. Johnny?
Good evening. How many of you people are friends of WMUB? I've been introducing music all day long, and I come over tonight, and I'm going to introduce some more music. Young people, it's really where it's at, you know. I want to mention that I walked these hallowed halls many years ago, but not here, because this was a cornfield when I went to way over there at Magsie, where I'm 40 years ago. And for your information, I was in the same class with your fine football coach, Bob Gregg. And Gordon Jump. So anyway, a little nostalgia there. The good looking group of people here. Are you guys nervous?
No.
Yeah, no. Those of you who aren't really familiar, and I can't imagine who that might be, but any of you who are not familiar with WMUB, we are 24-hour-a-day jazz big band format at 88.5 FM. We're located at Miami University in Oxford. And I talk to you all day long from 9:10 in the morning until 4, and mostly big bands. And spent some time this afternoon with Louie. You are in for a treat. So let's not wait any longer. And if you'd like to become a friend of WMUB, we got a fundraiser coming up, so keep that in mind. Right now, we'd like to turn these guys loose here. Jazz Ensemble 2, Mr. Tom Pompey. Thank you. He was the man I just played that piece a couple days ago. But same thing. Nice. Well, this is what you've all been waiting for. And like I said, I spent some time with Louis this afternoon. He's a wonderful individual, and you'll love him. So let's put your hands together and give a Centerville warm welcome to Mr. Louis Belson.
Basie Big Band. Next number we'd like to do is a ballad and features our vocalist, Miss Crystal Long. Someone to watch over me. To work with several jazz artists, and this year I think has been the most exciting. You're in for a real treat. Lou Delson's going to play four songs with Jazz Ensemble Number One, three in your program, and then Pressure Cooker at the end, which didn't quite make it into the program, but we'll be playing it and you won't want to miss it. You already know Willie Nelson is one of the greatest drummers. What I can tell you is he's been here for the last day and a half, and it's just been really exciting to meet somebody who is so warm and personable and works so well with high school musicians. He's so encouraging, and it's just been a real treat. Really, truly prince of a guy, Mr. Louie Bellson.
Brian and Jim. And of course, Lou Duncan.
Okay, we're going to shift gears here and do another one of Louis's tunes called Louis Tunes. This is kind of like a slow, bassy kind of tune. Put it right here.
Thank you.
band with Ben Pryor on piano and Chris Bauer on trumpet.
Next, we'd like to play a real contemporary blues kind of sound, Green Light Blues, written by Louis and arranged by Tommy Newsom.
Thank you.
John White on bass.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. This is my little time to come down and say a few little words of thanks for everyone, John, everybody, inviting me to come to this wonderful city and take part in this wonderful musical event. I just stand and look at all these youngsters, and I think of the time when I went to high school. We had a marching band and a concert band, and that was it. And we played poet and peasant until it came out of our ears. That was it. But then to see and hear them play charts that are right out of your book, like this next one coming up is one that we recorded with Sam Nestico, and we had the likes of Conti Condoli, Pete Christie, all those, Bill Watrous, all those great players, and we had to rehearse that tune. And nobody told them that it was hard, so they just played it. And that's what the Wayne Hubbard and Tom, both those band leaders and this wonderful guy, you should take a bow. There's something else. The other band, right in the front row here, too. First band to play. It's very easy for me. They call up and say, bring, you know, let's send the music on to us so we can rehearse it. And they meet me at the airport and immediately take me to the, what's that, Olive Garden? And feed me and put me in a great big suite. Enough for about five people with a big stove and a refrigerator and everything. You think I was going to make some homemade pasta in there? really treat you wonderful. Then get up on the bandstand and played my four tunes. And they said, "What else have you got?" You know. And it's really a delight. But somebody this afternoon said, "Hey, tell that story about you and Buddy Rich." And I said, "Well, I've already said it quite a few places. In fact, I did it at the wonderful Jazz Arts program, and I did it once from, there's another dear friend who lives not too far away, Columbus, Ohio, wonderful drummer, and he has his own big band, done so many things in the schoolwork. Let's say hello to Rick Brunetto right over here. Anyway, for those of you that had not heard it, it was a story that some of the major comedians like Henny Youngman and people like this were telling this story, where my time is up and I'm there at the gate to meet St. Peter, and he looks at me and says, "Well, it's about time. You're going to be our number one man up here." And I said, "Wait a minute, St. Peter. You've got Baby Dodd, you've got Chick Webb, you've got Gene Krupa, you've got Joe Jones." He said, "No, they've had their time. They've been up here for a while. Now you're going to be the number one man. In fact, you're going to play all the drum solos up here." And just as St. Peter said, "You're going to play all the drum solos up here," I hear this tremendous drum solo off in the distance. I said, "St. Peter, you said I'm going to play all the drum solos up here. That sounds like Buddy Rich." He said, "No, that's God. He thinks he's Buddy Rich." I'm still, that dear lady I was with for 39 years, a lot of people walk up and say, "Well, we remember seeing you and Pearl together, and I thank all of you because that's something I'll never forget." And I have my moments, but I was with the guys on Tonight Show not too long ago, and we started laughing because I started thinking, you know, they got a heck of a band up there in that sky. And I could just see, I just visualized my wife, Pearl, up there singing with that band. And then all of a sudden I realized the drummer is Buddy Rich. And I could just visualize my wife stopping the band right in the middle of a number and looking back at Buddy and saying, "Buddy, that's not the way Louie would do it." Now, we're going to do Pressure Cooker. You going to open up for the kid to play a little drums? Okay? All right. We know where to open it up, right? Okay? Pressure Cooker by San Nestico. This is featuring our first chair percussionist.
One more quick announcement. I'd like to introduce and thank the guy who put this whole concert together. We talked back in September or October about what we could do for a great jazz concert and a great jazz artist, and he immediately said, Louie Bellson. He did all the work, and it's been a lot of work, and we really appreciate it, plus the help of the Band Boosters and Buddy Rogers Music and Johnny Mack at WMUB. We thank all those people for putting it together. But it's been a great year for me because of this guy right here, Tom Pompei, my right arm.
Place of jazz.